Every single time I take a leave of absence off YouTube, which is pretty frequently, I feel like every time I come back, the site is in an entirely different place. My last upload was on Lego Star Wars. You probably didn't see it. It's only got 8,700 views, and I'm not upset about that. It was partially YouTube's fault and partially mine, because that was my first upload in 2 weeks. But because of these numbers, I'm assuming a lot of you haven't heard or seen from me for a while, and I want to apologize for that. I'm not going to make excuses. I think that a big reason for my absence was laziness, but I did also have a side project I had to do, and then I got pretty sick. I ended up getting prescribed a bunch of stuff, and I'm doing better now, for those of you who care. The whole purpose of the intro is literally just to plug this video. I think it came out pretty good. It was a funny video to make, so that'll be linked if you want to see it. If you don't want to see it, it's your prerogative. Have a good day. Thanks for watching this video, guys. I'll see you in the next one. This joke is ruined. I can't actually roll my outro because the song started getting copyrighted every single time I posted it, so. Anyways, it has been like 2 months since I've done a Steam video, like an actual proper buy random Steam keys and play the games video, and you guys like those way too much. So I figured that today we could kick it up a notch. You know, we're always trying to better ourselves out here on the channel, and I found this new key thing that they have, which is buy Epic Random Key, and apparently we can win any of the games in this list. There are honestly some pretty ambitious titles in here. We got stuff like Battlefield 5, you know, Fallout 76, the commercial classic that changed gaming forever. We got Portal 2, the nice classic from 2011, whenever that came out. Stardew Valley, I wouldn't mind getting.
The bottom line is there's some really epic games in here. I can't wait to get some epic games from here.
While the listing does show that I can win things like Grand Theft Auto 5, Just Cause 4, whatever, chances are I'm actually going to be getting something like Dino D-Day or House of a Thousand Doors, Family's Secret. I'm about to blow your mind, okay? I don't think you're ready. I'm not just buying one epic random key. I'm not just buying two epic random key. I am buying four. Three. I am buying three epic random keys today, okay? Now listen, I'm gonna level with you guys. This video is costing me a whopping $12.80. That's almost $13, all right? If I go to a super relevant and edgy website like HotTopic.com, I'm missing out on the perfect opportunity to purchase something that could change my life. Something like the black pleather checkered bralette. I could buy this for $6.39 right now, but instead, I'm spending twice that amount to bring you guys some daily entertainment. Can't even say daily, I upload once a month. Not only could I buy one black pleather checkered bralette, I could buy two. That is life, that is double the pleather, okay? But instead, I'm choosing to spend that money where it matters. And that's on you guys. If the $12.80 that I'm putting forth in this video is not worth a like on this video, well, God, please just strike me down right now. Make the stage lights fuck. What the fuck am I saying? All I ask is that you guys leave a like for my valiant effort. Thank you. I've actually been recording for 31 minutes and I haven't even purchased these games yet. You guys remember how I talked about this whole crazy list of games like 3 times and how crazy all the games were on the list? Well, you'll be happy to know that I got absolutely shafted. $13 later, we were awarded with Brigador Up Armored Edition, Maze, and Snake Pass. After pulling these games up on the Steam Marketplace, it seems that they all go for exactly $19.99. So I basically got $60 worth of games, but it looks like I got about $0 worth of fun. This game is about sentient corn. I don't want to be that guy. I don't want to be the guy that's like, oh, all these games are going to suck. I haven't played them. But I'm not playing these. They suck. They look awful. I was hoping I could get Fallout 76 so that I could do a proper review without actually having to purchase the game. But it doesn't seem like that's a possibility for today. So let's start it up with Brigador Up Armored Edition. Right off the bat, opening this, there's zero audio. My headset is for sure on. It's on, right? It's on? Ha! No, never mind. My headset wasn't on. That makes a little bit more sense. We're gonna start on the first level, which is Beginner's Falafel. Apparently, that's what I look like. Boy, engage. Okay. This is the absolute epic game that I just paid $12 to play. This looks like a riot. This just, oh man. Wow, I can do this.
It's cool. Stomp. I'm literally just blowing up crowds of people, dog. This is literally like some Terminator shit. What is this? Am I just causing as much damage as I can? Like, I'm a dude. I'm in this mech suit. It shows what I look like. Why am I killing these people? Why is there no background to this? Look at how high res this mech suit is, dude. Like, I am ready to go into this 480p gameplay. Let's get it. This game is like a 2D side-scrolling adventure. I'm not really sure what these games are actually called, like what genre this really is, but this is the goal. Just destroying everything, I guess. Super satisfying gameplay, knowing that this was a car and now it's not a car. That's fantastic. It looks like I'm actually met with some opposition in this level. So I think my goal is to kill all of the enemy tanks and pick up their orb, but it's honestly more fun to just blow up the town. Like, these are what? These gotta be like $1 million houses at least. I don't know why they're all the same house and they share a backyard, but let's just level the whole town, you know? That's the right way to handle this. And just there you go. Mission complete. Just gotta get to the exit now. Yeah, that was what am I doing with my time? This game is like a top-down weird arena combat game, and you just blow up tanks. That's what I gathered from this. If this looks like it might be your kind of game and you actually want to pay $20 for this, have fun. But this is not my cup of tea, to say the least. Graphically, the game actually isn't awful. The textures are low poly, but it kind of fits the aesthetic of the game, and like everything in your environment is destructible, so that's kind of cool, I guess. The game has very good reviews, like I'll give it that. For what it is, it's a solid game. Like, it plays well. I don't even know what kind of game is. It just says action indie. Doesn't seem that fun to me, but you know, every time I give my opinion, every single time, every time I input myself into how I feel in real life and in videos, I get a lot of shit. So, you know, overwhelmingly positive reviews. I'm an overwhelmingly positive guy. You know, I don't know what to say on YouTube anymore to not get demonetized. If this looks fun to you, pay $20 for it. That's all I got to say. I don't know. What do you want from me? I think mechanically the game was solid. And like I said, the reviews are good, but this is not the kind of game that I like to occupy my time playing. I prefer games like Snake Pass. You see, that's what we call a seamless transition in the video making world. I was talking about something else, right? I was talking about the first game that we played, and I wrapped it full circle by bringing it to the second game that I'm about to play. I may or may not be the best content creator on YouTube. Every time I record videos on these garbage ass games, I feel more and more like I'm losing my sense of self. Like, I literally think as I play these games how unfunny and ridiculous I'm being. But then I remember the games that I'm playing and the fact that there's no actual content in most of them. So sorry for that. Just know I'm trying my best. So coming next is gonna be a game that I used to play a lot as a child, Viva Pinata. No, this game really does remind me of like Viva Pinata though. I'm not really sure what's doing. We're gonna find out. This game does look more polished than the last one. It has actual graphics, so that's cool. Except you move forward with left click and you move side to side with A and D. What the fuck is this game, dude? What am I doing? I think, do I get longer when I eat these? How is this working for me? Is this the whole game? Pick up speed by slithering left and right with period? So I'm a snake and I have to, I got a strafe, I guess. This is pretty hard to control, to be honest. This isn't a bad game. This is pretty cool. It's forcing me to play the tutorial, which I'm not a fan of, but I could get down with this, except if you hold the space bar, your snake just looks straight up at the sky. That's not how snakes work. What happens when I hit this bar? Oh, I just go up and over it. This is how snakes slither. Have you ever wondered what snakes look like in the wild? Well, I've got news for you. It's like this. I really need to find some new content for my channel. Why is this bird in the center of my camera? What was that? This game is wild, dude. The camera's stuck on the fucking, All right, let's go. Every time I get anywhere, this stupid bird stops me, and this is why I hate tutorials. I hate forced tutorials in games, man. Drop down this thing, or just, or just sit on it. We just go into the light beam. Okay.
When you beat a level, it says sublime, which is pretty cool. Except there's three S's and it actually says sublime.
That's the stupidest thing I've ever seen, but let's continue. Where's like Navi from Zelda? It won't leave me alone. There's climbing mechanics in this game. Wow, would you just look at that? These controls are so hard to use, dude. They are so hard to use. To give you a rough idea of how the control scheme works in this game, I'm holding down the space bar, the left click, and the W key nonstop, and I'm able to accomplish just about everything that this game has to offer so far. In my opinion, it does interrupt gameplay way too much with the stupid birds cutscenes, but I think that's just because I'm in the beginning of the game and it's forcing a tutorial on me. Realistically, instead of a tutorial, they probably should have just made the controls better for this game. It's really, really hard to move the snake around efficiently, mainly because you have to use the fucking left click to accelerate. It just doesn't make any sense. How do I get up here? How do I get up here? I just hold space and climb the pole. Obviously, who wouldn't have thought of that, you know? You got all these beams and bars that you can supposedly climb, but literally all you have to do is hold space by this pole and you'll just slither right up the pole. Giant debilitating wall? No problem. Just hold space and you'll go right up it. That's how snakes work. What is going on here, man? What? I'm trying to go forward. I'm trying to go forward, dude. My God. They unintentionally made a rage game here. They really did. What jackass at the studio was presented with this idea?
Oh yeah, it's a game where you're just a snake and you just crawl up some poles and grab some blue orbs. That's what this game is about. You know, we need a budget of $10 million to get the project done.
And then the fucking studio executive is like,
oh yeah, $10 million, that's it? Oh yeah, when will development start?
And he's like, if you sign the contract, development can start today. And the game only took a day to develop, and that was the whole point of my joke. I'm actually not gonna lie, this game is pretty trash, but it has an odd charm to it. It's a game that I could like see myself wasting time on, but not something that I would actually like enjoy playing. Like if all of my friends just decided that they hated me, this might be something that I would open up and play, but not for $20. This is a whack title for $20. I can't even, if I could actually find a way properly explain to you guys how excruciatingly bad the controls are here, you would understand. And you would probably agree with me. I just like, for what this game is, why would you want to put yourself through this? That's like the question that I keep asking myself. With that, I'm going to move on to the next game because I am very quickly losing my patience with this one. The last game that we have is called Maze. This game is also $20 and it's about corn. I'm not going to pretend that it's not. The game is about corn. We really struck out hard today. I have high hopes for this one. I'm hoping that it's not gonna be totally trash. I need some sort of redeeming factor because I just spent $13 and I really don't want it to be for nothing. Guys, I'm not trying to short you out of content or anything, but I extended the footage from the other two games so I could show this one the least because this is actually a genuinely good game and you'll hear me talk about it in a minute. I do wanna make a full video on this game because I think it would make for some good content. So I hope that's cool, but here's a general overview of what's going on. Am I a piece of corn in this or am I not corn? Like, are we fighting corn? All I know is that the game is about corn. I don't know if I am corn, or if I'm fighting corn, or if it's just a maze game in some corn. Pressing Q does absolutely nothing. It's this kind of game. It's the kind of game that's gonna tell me controls that don't exist. I'm actually kinda not sure what's going on, though, to be honest. Press E to examine your equipped item. English muffin. Hard as granite, this muffin is most definitely nowhere near fit for consumption. What the fuck? I think this actually is a puzzle game, and that makes me happy because I enjoy puzzle games. The graphics in this game really aren't bad, and it's seeming like it's a puzzle game, so that's like two major pluses right off the bat. I'm actually vibing with this one a little bit, I'm not gonna lie. What the fuck is that, dude?
The couple that lived here, I'm not gonna lie, like, they're a good looking couple. Mama a little bit thick. I'm not gonna say she ain't. How are you gonna look at that girl and say she ain't a little bit thick, all right? And her husband's looking like the annoying orange out here. He looks like my left nut mixed with the annoying orange, bro. I dig that. I really dig that.
Unlocked secret door, making it much less secret. Okay. Secret cabinet door. Duh, obviously. Let's go into the corn basement, baby. Fuse box, missing a fuse. Ooh. Wait, who is this guy? Who is this? This is like the wife without makeup, but also as a man. Like, real quick, this is what this dude's wife looks like, okay? Hold on. I'm pretty sure that's the same person. I'm pretty sure that dude's wife is a husband. That means I said that, oh. I called his wife thick and her wife was a man. Oh man. It's a good thing it's 2019. My sexual preference is none of your goddamn business. That was actually pretty funny, I'm not gonna lie. No matter how many times you press it, Q still does nothing. I don't believe that. I feel like if I press Q enough, it's gonna do something because the game keeps telling me it doesn't do anything. Honestly, I would say out of all the games that I played today, this is definitely the one that is the most worth a buy. Stop pressing Q. Okay. On a real note, guys, I can pick this back up for you if you want me to in a separate video. I would happily make a video on this. This game was actually a lot of fun. This game goes for $20, and I think that it is definitely worth that price point. I don't know how long the campaign is, but even just from what I've played so far, it doesn't seem like it's planning on slowing down anytime soon. But even if it's only like a 2 or 3 hour long game, for like, $15, if you waited and got this on sale, like that's about what I paid for all of these games today. And I'd say that for the price I paid, this game is absolutely worth it. If this was the only game I got for the $12 that I spent, I would be 100% happy with it. I guess that goes to show that you're not necessarily gonna strike out if you're buying these random games. I usually go into this knowing that most of the games in here are gonna be absolute trash, but I'm very pleasantly surprised with this game. This is definitely the best game that I've gotten out of any of these random packs so far. And if you guys want to get this, I will actually have this linked in the description. It's not a sponsored thing or anything. I just really like puzzle games. Like, I'm genuinely happy about this game. Anyways, if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like on it. It may have been a little bit lower energy. I am just getting over being sick on a real note. But thank you so much for coming out here. Thank you if you made it to the end of this video. It's been a while since I've uploaded one of these, and I'm really happy to be back making content. I have a lot of new stuff coming for you guys. You know, we're pulling up on 200K. I'm pulling up with 200K. Like, life is good. Life is sweet. And for a limited time, if you like the video, I can send you one of these $100 bills. See, the trick is to skim 2% off of every penny that you make, and then you don't have to pay taxes on it with the IRS. That's how it works. 100%, trust me, no scam. In all actuality, it's Chinese money. It's fake money. Don't steal money from the government. I pay my taxes on time. I could have fooled you though. I could have fooled you though. I just dropped $100,000 on the floor. God damn it. I don't know what the point of that was. That was probably the weirdest flex I've ever done on the channel. Have a great day, guys. Thank you for watching the video, and I will see you in the next one. Peace out. Hey, guys, new outro song. The other one was copyrighted in too long, so I made this in like 2 seconds. Follow my Twitter, please.